Okay, what is grit and glamour?
Me? Well, growing up, my dad being a cowboy, a professional team roper and a championship header in the rodeo, that was the very soundtrack of my childhood, and country music was on repeat. Garth Brooks, Merle Haggard, Willie Nelson, Trisha Yearwood, George Strait. You know, we kind of gravitated towards the more Texas sound of that cowboy rodeo rancher, since that's how I was raised.
I am not camera ready.
My mom was the one that first really encouraged it when I was a little girl, about 3 years old, and I sat down at a piano, and most little kids sit down and bang, you know, and she said that I sat down, tried to make this really pretty melody in these notes, and she thought, okay, superstar, we're going for it. Ringing, here's my finger.
Well, you know, being from Southern California, there's LA, which is the mecca of music here, just like Nashville is the mecca of music in the South. So the next logical move is to LA.
I was sitting at a restaurant, and there was two women sitting next to us, me and my mom, and started talking, and it came up that I was a singer. One of the wives said, well, if you're any good, here is my address. She said, my husband's won 24 Grammys. So I was like, everybody's husband in something in this stinking town. But I sent it, and a week later I was recording with David Foster and Umberto Gatica. Track record is Kenny Loggins to Whitney Houston to Josh Groban to Michael Bublé. You name it, produced it. Just had amazing, amazing opportunities. I just felt never settled. I never felt that I was where I was supposed to be. When I would get in there and do the demo and do a lick or a certain ad lib or something, it would be like, whoa, that's too country. Can you, you know, not do that? Or can you not do this? And that's just even more of a testament to where I was supposed to be. Hold me back. So I prayed about it, and I felt that I needed to stop pulling out my roots and start watering them. I booked a flight 2 weeks later to Nashville. And my attorney introduced me to Jim Cutino, who's the vice president of A&R at Sony. I played him some work tapes, which I did not think I was ready to do. And in that meeting, the first meeting, he said, I'd like to sign you to Sony. And I was like, what? That's crazy. Let's hit the road and let the engines fart. We'll be singing out loud to the Rolling Stones. Well, I have a first single coming out. It's called Take the Keys. Everybody gets stuck in everyday life sometimes. And, you know, whether it's your best friend, partner, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your husband, your wife, it's nice to have a relationship to be able to say, you know what, I know we're stuck in some routines right now, but let's just, for today, roll down the windows and get the heck out of here, you know? And that's what it's about, telling him, come on, all right, shotgun, and you take the keys, and we will fall back in love over and over again. Back in love, over and over again. We'll be singing out loud to the Rolling Stones. Making up lines that we don't know. I would say that I got a little bit of grit and a little bit of glamour. I like to say that I have Tabasco running through my veins, but it's a sweet Tabasco, so it's not, you know, super tangy. Just a little spicy. So if I had to say there was an aha moment, it's holy crap, my dream is coming true. And that's here, coming home to country.